Welcome to another Lightblade Learning Lab. What we see here is basically where we finished off on the last session. We had a dilemma. We need full air assist for cutting and no air assist for engraving to get optimum results. So where you have a composite job like this, how are we going to solve this problem? There are three possible solutions that I can think of. The first solution, which we're going to talk about, is to break this program into two. So we'll run two programs. A bit messy, but doable. We'll go back to RDWorks and we will modify this program to deal with the issue.
Here's our original program. All we've got to do is something very simple. If we go to the cut layer parameters, is output yes? We'll swap that to no. That's all we have to do. Then I shall save this to a USB stick. And now we go to the scan layer. Is output no? And we save that as a program.
Okay, well, here we are back with our trial material so that we've got all the data that we need for comparison. Right, now we've got the air extraction on, so we've got a through flow of air. We'll turn the air assist off and we'll close the door. You can hopefully see the smoke being drawn away quite efficiently. And it stops. And now, without doing anything else, I'm just going to change the program to the cut program. And I'm also going to turn the air assist back on. And there we go, pain-free. Not a bad cut round the outside. No serious browning on there, but a little bit. But that's quite a nice clean job. And nothing on the back. Okay, now, that's one way that you can solve this problem. Break it into two programs.
Here is a slightly more elegant way of dealing with the problem. I say slightly more, because basically what we're going to do now is we're going to put both layers back to outputting. So we've put the cut and the scan back to normal, so they're both operating on the same program, still on different layers because we need different parameters, but they're operating in the same program. Even though it's shown up here as second in the list, etching will always take precedence over cutting. Okay, so what I'm now going to do is I'm just going to put an object in. It doesn't really matter what it is, just out here somewhere. I'm going to put that circle on a different layer. We're going to put it on a red layer. And we're going to make it a cut. Yes. Output, yes. Speed. So this is not a walkaway job. This is a stand by the machine job. And we're going to make that speed operate at, say, something fairly slow. Maybe 2 millimeters a second. 2 millimeters a second. And the power? Well, we're going to set the power down to 1%. Now, 1% is not going to cut. So what's going to happen in this instance, when it gets to the red layer, it's going to go out here and it's very slowly, at 2 millimeters a second, going to traverse around this circle. Now, when you see it going out there, what you're going to do is you're either going to press the pause button or you're going to lift the lid and then you're going to turn the air assist on. So you start off with the air assist off and then you turn it on. Now, in this particular instance, we've got to make sure that things happen in the right order. So we want the black layer to happen after the red layer. And we'll just test that to make sure it's all working okay. Wrong. I haven't got anything set up in my cut optimize. I always leave mine completely open, if you remember. And so what I normally do, I do cut optimize and I'll set the cutting properties. Now I know what I want to do. I won't have a choice about doing this, but we shall have to put it in first. And then we want to do this element here next. And then finally we want to do the outside. Job done. Now it will work.
Right, for this next test, we need the air assist off, because we're going to do the engraving to start with, close the door. Now, we don't have to panic, because you'll see the machine at the end of the engraving will go to the corner and we get ready with the pause button to pause the cycle. There we go. It's starting to go round a circle. And if I let it go again, look, you'll see that it's not actually cutting. See that? Very slowly. Now that means we can stop at this point, mid-program, turn the air assist on, and close the door again, and press the pause button, start. So that's another alternative way. But as I was drawing that program, I had a light bulb moment. I was going to show you something else, another way of achieving the same result, when all of a sudden I felt like a real idiot. Been a key by that door that I've been walking by for the last 2 years. I didn't realise that that key unlocked that door.
Back in RDWorks, and we'll open up the cutting parameters for this particular little project. And if we start from the top, we see we're on the scan layer. And it asks the question, is output yes? Well, we know what that means. Do you want to actually produce a program for this layer or not? And we're going to set the speed as fast as we can. And then we've got this question here. Is blowing? No, it says if blowing. It's the same question, is blowing? And we have the choice of answering it yes or no. Now, from day one when I started using RDWorks, I could never puzzle out why this question was here. First of all, if you could switch the blowing on and off, and I didn't know whether the blowing initially was to do with the extraction system or the air assist system. Being Chinese, it could have been either. But in reality, what it is asking is, do you want the air assist on or off? Logic says that you always want it on, because if you turn it off, then you could finish up smoking the lens. As we found out from our experiments, although basically I've turned the air assist off, I haven't fully turned it off. There's a certain amount of leakage past the valve, which is actually making sure there's positive pressure flowing out of the nozzle and hence protecting the lens. So although I've got it turned off, I haven't really. It's just regulated right the way down to almost nothing. But we've got this question here which asks us, do we want blowing or not? Technically, we don't want blowing. So let's answer that question, no. We're in scan mode. We're going to do that at 30% power and 30% power. Okay. Now let's check the cut mode. And here again, is output? Yes, we do want the output. Speed we've set. Is blowing, if blowing, yes or no? Well, this is cutting, and we know absolutely that for cutting we need air assist, and as much of it as we can get. So we leave that set to yes, and we're running at 67% power. So let's save that program and go and see what it does.
For this next trial, we're going to try something completely different, and I think you might find this rather interesting. No, I hope we're not going to get any flames, but hey, let's see what happens. I'm going to close the lid, because bear in mind, with engraving, we need to blow across the surface. okay, that was interesting, wasn't it? Now, I've purposely used this very light laser cutting hardboard, or MDF, because I wanted to exaggerate the situation. I would like you to see just how smoke-free the inside and the outside of the letters are. And the cut around the edge is not bad either, but the cut around the edge we can now have a go at doing something about, because the two processes are separate but together. How did I achieve that? So you've seen how we've programmed to create this lovely end result. How have we done it on the machine itself? Well, what we've done, we've got a 24 volt solenoid valve. It's a two-way three-port valve. And basically what happens is this, the air comes in, and in a normal rest condition, like we are at the moment, we've got no air passing through here. Well, I say no air, we've basically got a very limited flow through this restrictor here. And it's just enough to bubble past the nozzle and give the lens protection. RDWorks says if blowing, and you answer yes. What you're really doing is switching on this solenoid valve, changing this direction of flow from here to here. And it passes straight through the valve and you get full flow through the nozzle. Now you can regulate that flow with the ball valve that is still adjacent to the head. So if you want half flow or quarter flow, you can do that with the ball valve still. But basically what you've got the option here of doing is yes is cutting and no is engraving. And now you can combine both of those into one program by setting the layers with different blowing parameters. After we've looked at these engraving trials and cutting trials, all of a sudden it's become clear what this function is, and I've had to modify the machine myself to make it happen. Now, this is not something that either Thinklaser or any other Chinese machine that I'm aware of has fitted as standard. But I dare say that if you really do need this approach to engraving, then you could probably ask for Thinklaser to fit it as an optional extra. I mean, I know that they modify their machines to suit all customer requirements. You can ask them to do anything. You know, if you want to bake cakes on this machine, they can probably do that for you as well. Baking a cake, but it's close. Thanks a lot for joining me today. I hope that's been a very interesting session. I did say that I was on a journey of discovery, and hey, I've certainly discovered something. Maybe there are many guys out there in the laser world that already knew this, but they haven't told me. So I've had to find out for myself. And along the way, well, this little trial tastes a bit smoky. Anyway, I'll see you in the next session.